Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan. Welcome to the Arabic Fluency channel. And in this video, we're going to talk about a very special Sahabi who was known as the poet of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was also the one who was helped by Jibreel to say poetry. Keep listening to find out more.
وَمَنْ يُنْفِقُ السَّاعَاتَ فِي جَمْعِ مَالِهِ مَخَافَةَ فَقْرٍ فَالَّذِي فَعَلَ الْفَقْرِ وَإِذَا ظُلِمْتُ فَإِنَّ ظُلْمِي بَاسِرٌ مُرٌّ مَذَاقَتُهُ كَطَعْمِ الْعَلْقَ أَلَمْ تَعْلَمِي أَنِّي إِذَا الضَّيْفُ نَابَنِي وَعِزِّ الْقِرَى أَقْرِ السَّدِيفَ الْمُسَرْهَدَ.
So this Sahabi, as you might have guessed, is none other than Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu. Now the Quraysh was attacking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam using poetry. And this was causing a lot of pain to the Muslims, because you have to understand that poetry was the media of that time. You know, a single line of poetry was sometimes powerful enough to destroy the image and reputation of an entire tribe. A single line of poetry can destroy a person or exalt him. So this was the power of poetry. So this was a serious threat. And the Prophet ﷺ wanted to give reply to the Quraysh using poetry. So the first person the Prophet ﷺ asked was Abdullah ibn Rawaha radiallahu anhu. And he composed lines replying to the Quraysh, but the Prophet ﷺ was not satisfied. And then he asked Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. Again, the Prophet ﷺ was not satisfied with the poetry. And finally, he asked Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu. Hassan ibn Thabit entered upon the Prophet ﷺ and he said, قَدْ آنَ لَكُمْ أَن تُرْسِلُوا إِلَىٰ هَذَا الْأَسَدِ الطَّارِبِ بِذَنَبِهِ. It is time that you call for this lion which hits its enemies with its tail. And he took out his tongue and shook it. So he was talking about his tongue. And he told the Prophet ﷺ, وَالَّذِي بَعْثَكَ بِالْحَقِّ لَأَفْرِيَنَّهُمْ بِلِسَانِي فَرِّيَ الْأَدِيمِ. By the one who has sent you with the truth, O Prophet of Allah, I will cut through them with my tongue, like cutting through leather. The Prophet ﷺ said, لَا تَعَجَلْ. Do not be hasty, because when you attack the Quraysh, you might end up attacking me, because I have the same lineage as the Quraysh. I am from the Quraysh, so you need to be careful. So he said, go to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu first and learn the lineage, because Abu Bakr was the most knowledgeable about the lineage, the history of the Quraysh and who was who and all that. So then Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu, he went to Abu Bakr and learned about the lineage. And then he came back to the Prophet sallallahu and he said, وَالَّذِي بَأَثَكَ بِالْحَقِّ, by the one who has sent you with the truth, لَأَسُلَّنَّكَ مِنْهُمْ كَمَا تُسَلُّ الشَّعْرَةُ مِنَ الْعَجِينِ. I will take you out from them like a strand of hair is taken out from the flower. Meaning, I will attack the Quraysh and this will not affect the Prophet ﷺ in any way. So, this story is narrated in Sahih Muslim. This is an authentic story. And Aisha radiallahu anha, who is telling us this story, she says, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell Hassan, the Ruh al-Qudus, Jibreel alayhi salam, will continue helping you as long as you are defending Allah and His Messenger. Subhanallah. So then what are the lines that Hassan composed? The main person attacking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Abu Sufyan, who was not a Muslim back then. And later he accepted Islam and he is a Sahabi. But at this time he was not a Muslim. So Hassan was addressing Abu Sufyan with these lines. أَجَوْتَ مُحَمَّدًا فَأَجَبْتُ عَنْهُ وَعِنْدَ اللَّهِ فِي ذَاكَ الْجَزَاءُ. You have attacked Muhammad and I am giving reply to you. And in doing so, my ajr, my reward is with Allah. أَتَحْجُوهُ وَلَسْتَ لَهُ بِكُفْوٍ فَشَرُّكُمَا لِخَيْرِكُمَ الْفِدَاءُ. Do you attack him, O Abu Sufyan, and he is not your equal? You are not equal to him. And the worst one amongst the two of you is fida, he is ransom for the best one. So Abu Sufyan is ransom for the Prophet ﷺ, meaning they are not equal. Muhammad ﷺ, he is a greater man. He is much more valuable. And then he said, and this is the real hijah, this is the real attack. He said, Inna sanam al-majdi min ali hashimin banu binti makhzumin waliduka al-abdu. The honor and glory of Banu Hashim, the tribe of the Prophet ﷺ, they belong to the children of Bint Makhzum. Bint Makhzum was Fatima, the grandmother of the Prophet ﷺ, the mother of Abdullah, the father of the Prophet ﷺ. As for you, your mother was a slave of Abu Sufyan. The mother of Abu Sufyan was a slave. وَأَنْتَ حَجِينٌ نِيطَ فِي آلِ هَاشِمٍ. You are a hajin. Hajin is a person whose father is an Arab, but his mother is not an Arab, a slave woman, for example. So they didn't consider him a full Arab. So he says, you are such a person. نِيطَ فِي آلِ هَاشِمٍ. And Al-Hashim, the tribe of Hashim, have taken you along. You're not really from them, but they have just taken you along. Like a vessel that is hung behind the rider and taken along. You're not really a full Arab part of Banu Hashim. You are just someone they have accepted and taken along. And subhanAllah, this is a very powerful hijah. So when the Quraysh heard these lines, they said, Abu Bakr has something to do with this, because no one knew the lineage in detail like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And it is reported that the Prophet ﷺ said, Ajahum Hassan fashafa washtafa. Hassan has attacked them and he has brought pleasure to the Muslims and he has made the kuffar quiet. There's nothing to say after this. He completely destroyed them. So this was Hassan, the sha'ir, the poet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I want to end with a few lines attributed to Hassan, praising the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Wa ahsanu minka lam tara qattu ayni." My eyes have not looked upon anything more beautiful than you, O Rasulullah. وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. And no woman has given birth to anyone more handsome than you, O Rasulullah. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. O Rasulullah, you have been created without any imperfection. You have been created without any fault. It is as though you were created the way you wanted. What does this mean? If we could choose our physical creation, we could choose what kind of body we want to have, what kind of face, what kind of eyes, what would we choose? We would choose to have the best, the most perfect, right? This was the khalq of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was as though he chose the most perfect for himself, the way he wanted it. Subhanallah wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahabihi ajma'in. And this was Hassan radiyallahu anhu, the poet of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I will see you in the next video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.